I just love biking because it takes me outside. I need to do a lot of exercise to help treat my Parkinson's. 12 years ago, on the eve of my 57th birthday, I was standing in the hallway of the long corridor in the hospital. Had a long white coat on, and I was pretty tired. And I guess I was flexed forward, bent over, and one person was coming down the hall, and he's a well-known neurologist, and he walked up to me and said, you have Parkinson's disease. There's no way to diagnose Parkinson's disease like with a blood test or an x-ray or a diagnostic test. It's a clinical diagnosis. And I practiced as a physician for 30 years, and I couldn't even see that I was put it all together. I had difficulty with mobility. I had difficulty with stiffness and rigidity, and my posture was a little bit flexed forward. Characteristically, for the first 5 years or so, people with Parkinson's respond to medication. And I took a number of them in sequence, but toward the end of that period, which was now going almost on 10 years, I had less response and more side effects. That's when DBS, or deep brain stimulation, was offered as an option. And that sent me off into the whole planning stages to get the DBS, which is very extensive preparation, different consultations, having speech therapy evaluations, having seen a neurosurgeon, discussing the case thoroughly, having MRIs, psychological testing, and testing for cognitive issues. That was all required. Put in the electrodes in your right side of your brain, in my situation, and the second operation is to put this neurostimulator under your collarbone, just where a pacemaker for the heart would be. And what it does is it generates a small amount of electricity, which goes through wires, up over my collarbone, behind my ear, through the previously open surgical hole here in the brain, and then down towards the electrode. And there are certain things I can control. There's a patient controller. I can control the voltage. It changed my life immediately. Immediately, I was having on time. I was able to go to the gym more. I was able to get dressed. Basic activities of daily living, we call them ADLs. But today, I'd say that the quality of care that I received and the expertise of the physicians and the supportive staff at Scripps was second to none. I feel they care about your whole physical and emotional reaction to this disease. And I just felt very confident that they were going to provide me with excellent care. Thank you for supporting me and caring for me, and for being persistent in encouraging me to consider the next step in my care, which clearly was the need for DBS surgery.